Hey YouTube, Gundam here. Welcome back to Space Engineers. I've got a new Corvette for everybody. This little guy.
You should remember from Star Wars Rebels and from what's that? Rogue One. Yeah, one of these things crashes into a Star Destroyer and sends it for a twirl. So, the Hammerhead Corvette. I brought the Corellian Corvette down here, and you haven't noticed, I haven't noticed until recently, this thing's upside down. How do you know it's upside down? Well, this for one, and the door for the other, and the seat. It doesn't matter. At any rate, this is the Hammerhead Corvette for the Rebel Alliance. It's actually quite the lightly armored ship. If we take a look at this thing, this isn't very heavily armed, but armed. There's these two forward laser cannons, two rotary blasters, and I believe eight laser cannons. There are more. No, it looks like there's, oh yeah, that's right, it's 8, 10, then 12. So eight laser cannons, two rotaries, and two forward lasers. So what does this thing have? Believe it or not, this thing only has five laser cannons. There's one here. Yeah, which means it has a very limited field of fire. There's two on either side of the doors. And one at the top. And one at the bottom. That's it. And I was very hesitant to even give it the one to the top and bottom. It doesn't have that. I decided it needs it. It's just too lacking in firepower. The Hammerhead Corvette has a single rotary blaster here, which means it has a limited field of fire. So then what in the world is that thing there? Judging by the size of the barrel, I'd say it's a turbo laser. The Hammerhead Corvette sacrifices a significant amount of its firepower to get a turbo laser.
It's a Corvette with a turbo laser.
You will notice there is no forward firing engine, I mean guns on this thing, unlike the other ships. But here's something that it also doesn't have. See this entire front section? Notice how the blocks appear a little bit different? This entire front is made out of heavy armor blocks. From here back is all light armor, but that front is heavy armor. A little nod to Rogue One, where it rams something. So trying to shoot at this thing from the front, well, there's some guns shooting back at you, but you're not going to do much damage because of the heavy armor. Now the Hammerhead Corvette is also the only Corvette to have something else. We'll see that in the innards, but yes, heavy armor on the front. Let's take a look around this ship, shall we? The cockpit. It's very intricately designed to allow for its oxygen tank and its single oxygen generator to function for its very small crew. The oxygen vent is there. No internal turrets, but notice there are three command chairs. That's for the pilot to fly around in. One for the rotary blaster and one for the turbo laser. You can choose which one. Underneath, you have the cryo units here so they can take turns. Underneath, you have the gravity generator, so there is gravity. But then underneath, you have a gyroscope. And that's it. That's it in this. It's all heavy armor. Now, this is just decoration here, but going up to this, you won't see anything until you come here. A series of thrusters, followed by gyroscopes, nuclear reactors, and cargo containers. Immediately behind, gyroscopes, and two big nuclear reactors, and a giant cargo container. That's in that big section there. So you want to herd the ship, you herd it there. Or you can cut it in half here, but good luck. It's not easy. I'll get to that in a minute. Going around the outside, you see the antenna there, the turbo laser, the connection port, and the engines in a rather particular formation. Plenty of thrust forward, But the sage thrusters are turned off. This is my nod to the, basically it has an ability of boost engine power to, allow it to push things it's rammed into. It rams into something not going fast, and then it pushes it by activating these. But you don't have to do that. I just say so. So now, finally going back here, we have a motherload of gyroscopes, cargo containers, and nuclear reactors. It's a ton of reactors and cargo containers in here. But it's mostly reactors. This thing is heavily endowed with reactor power. There's the beacon and the jump drive. It is jump capable. Now you'll notice more and more and more gyroscopes in here. All over the darn place. There's even some over here. There's one of the sage thrusters. I'm inside of an engine here. There's another sage thruster, another sage thruster. Now there's a big empty room here to allow the reverse engines with more and more and more gyroscopes everywhere. But what is the thing that I said this ship has that no other Corvette has? It's just behind the jump drive. Actually, excuse me, it's just below the jump drive. That's a shield generator. It's a single shield generator, but the other Corvettes don't have one. They're just too small. This one does. And the reason it doesn't have a weak spot painted red is there's a turret in the way, which happens to slap the camera. But yes, there's a turret here. So if you want to take out the shield generator, you have to hit that turret. But there's a problem. Look at the location. Unless you're firing basically from this angle, you're not going to hit that shield. It's not going to be easy. It also has the ability that the connectors are sunken in a little bit. Make it harder to reach them. No, it just makes it more flush with the rest of the ship. Other ships don't have that, but then again, this reduces the overall size significantly. So it may not have much firepower, but then again, a turbo laser does hurt. Now it's not going to hurt as much as having a whole lot more laser cannons, but then again, the Nebulon over there, that's special. Yeah. Here's the thing, though. The ship here, the Hammerhead Corvette, has two things three things rather, that no other Corvette has. It has a turbo laser, which, okay, it's only one, but it's gonna do some damage. It has a large amount of heavy armor blocks. In fact, this thing has nearly as many heavy armor blocks as that thing has in its neck, if you were to divide that thing's neck in two. It actually has only about half. But the point is, it just emphasizes how weak the neck on the Nebulon frigate is. The frigate's neck is incredibly weak. There's heavy armor everywhere, including on the bottom here and on the sides, but that's it. It is the definitive weak spot because there's no reactors there and there's no thrusters there. You hit that, you kill the ship. This thing, there are reactors around, there's thrusters only in the back, but then again, that's the same with the other Corvette. Okay, this has two thrusters here and two there, but none in the other directions. This has nothing except for in the back there. Now, there are no batteries on this thing. No batteries. That's another problem. It relies heavily on its reactors, but it has a lot of them. It loses power from its reactors. It's in trouble. The Hammerhead Corvette, it really struggles to find a decent place, except as a rammer. It can take a beating. All that heavy armor, plus a shield generator. It's only one, but they don't have any. They don't have any. This does. The Hammerhead Corvette is seriously packing defense. The other Corvettes all go for offense and then balance speed in. So they balance their speed and their offense. They all have a pretty poor defense, even the IPV. The IPV is just bigger, but the IPV has a lot more firepower, but it's very, very slow. The Hammerhead, on the other hand, well, it's not necessarily slower. First off, the weight. Whoops. First off is the weight of the Hammerhead. Do you see that there? 40 million? 40 million kilos. I want to show you something. The Hammerhead Corvette is 40 million kilos. Okay? The Corellian Corvette is 2.7 million kilos. That's it, just 2.7. It's not even 3 million. But how about something a little bigger? Now this is a lot bigger actually. But this thing weighs 120 million. But it is bigger, but how much bigger is it? At 120 million. It's not too much bigger. It's all those heavy armor blocks. This thing would weigh about the same as the others, except for the heavy armor. 40 million. That is pretty darn heavy. Now, maneuverability. Well, going up. 5. 10. So it's not the fastest. I actually gotta get more to get out of here. There's 15. So it's not the fastest going up, but, well, I mean, again, look at the size. Compared to the Nebulon B, which weighs 3 times as much, but the Nebulon's B a lot bigger. Man, this is really starting to feel like Empire at War here. It'll feel good once I get the Vindicator out there, or an Acclimator, but yeah, I digress. So it isn't slow, it's just not particularly quick. Going to the left, it does struggle. There's 5. Denton. Now all ships stop on a dime, but yeah. I'm gonna get some more room here. This space is getting crowded. Now reversing, 5, 10, 15, 20. Here's the thing though. It does have a lot of reverse engines on the front there, and there's a lot hiding inside. But forward thrust has 2 modes. This is the standard forward thrust. 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. It seems rather slow, but this thing has 3 Sage engines. And I just brought them online. I just realized I never flew them. So here we go in 3, 2, 1. 10, 20, 30, 40. Despite it weighing 40 million kilos, it's quick. So, don't mess with this ship. It is pretty quick. It's lacking in armament, but it has a really strong front, and it has shields on a Corvette. Don't mess with it. It won't kill you very quickly, but it can take the beating to be able to kill you in time. Hammerhead.